This demonstration video will show how to digitize material polygons and assign roughness values to each polygon. Roughness values are applied to our mesh by creating polygons in a materials coverage and assigning Manning's end values to each polygon. We could create a new materials coverage like we did previously, but in this case we'll create it by duplicating the mesh generator coverage. Let's now rename the coverage to Materials. We also need to change its coverage type from Mesh Generator to SRH2D Materials. Note that the polygons have a crosshatch pattern. This implies that the material for these polygons has not yet been assigned. Next, we'll create a list of materials that we'll use to represent the land cover for our model domain. Let's start by right-clicking on the materials coverage and selecting Material List and Properties. Note that in the Material List and Properties dialog, there is only a single material named Unassigned. We'll now create four additional materials by clicking the plus sign in the lower left corner four times. The four new materials will be used to represent our channel, short grass, shrubs, and roadway. We'll now change the Manning's end value for each material. Before we close this dialog, let's change the color and texture of each material to something that more closely represents the land cover itself. We've now created four new materials for our study area. Our next step is to digitize polygons that represent each land cover. The channel polygon was already created when we duplicated our mesh generator coverage. To create the materials polygons, we'll use the Create Feature Arc tool to digitize material zones for our four materials. We'll use the aerial photo for guidance. Again, we need to click Build Polygons to generate the material zone polygons. Next, we need to assign a material to each polygon we've just created. This is done by using the Select Feature Polygon tool and double-clicking on each polygon. This opens the Assign Material dialog. We'll now select a material from the list to assign it to this polygon. We now need to repeat this process for each polygon in our model domain. It's important for a material to be assigned to each polygon. If a polygon does not have an assigned material, the default is the unassigned material. An unassigned material won't allow water to flow in that portion of the model domain. This concludes part two of our demonstration. We've gone over creating material polygons and assigning roughness values. You will follow similar steps as you do the second lesson for this exercise.